things you'll do for me. Nobody can do the miracles you bring my way. It'll blow my mind, oh, it led to my way. Nothing can break through you. Can I be here or see your wonder in my life?
God bless you, my beloved brethren. I want to welcome every one of you to this glorious Bible study session. I strongly believe that God is set ready to impact us with his wisdom and power that will renew his grace and glory in every area of our life. Therefore, I want you to open your heart and release your spirit as you connect with this broadcast today in this special Bible study session. And I strongly believe that the Spirit of the Lord will pour down God's blessings and God's glory and God's abundant grace upon you on every side in the name of Jesus Christ. Let us bow our heads in prayer. Lord Jesus, we thank you again for today, for the privilege and the opportunity to gather before you. Wherever everyone is connecting with this broadcast today, I pray, Father, let the power of the Holy Spirit reach out unto them. Let their afflictions be terminated. Let every challenge of God be terminated. Let every concern be addressed in their heart. Speak a word to everyone today. Let everyone that is taking part in today's broadcast, let their portion of today's blessing be allocated to them in the name of Jesus Christ. Holy Spirit of God, we trust in you that every time we come to receive your word, the Bible says you send your word and your word healeth us and your word deliver us from all our destruction. Therefore, in the name of Jesus, as your word begin to come this hour, I pray in the name of Jesus, let every chain be broken from the life of everyone in the name of Jesus Christ. Let the blessings of your salvation, let the fullness of your testimonies be made manifest in the life of your people in the name of Jesus Christ. Let the sick be healed. Let the oppressed be delivered. Let the captive be set free. Let the barren become fruitful mothers of children in the name of Jesus Christ. Break the hold of barrenness. Destroy the affliction of the devil. And let everyone that is connecting with this broadcast today, let the blessings of hope and restoration visit them on every side. Let every heart be strengthened. Let the weak be empowered. And let the joy of heaven fill the heart and the soul and the spirit of everyone today. Send your word, touch my tongue once again with the coal of fire, and let your word impact every life with great revelation and knowledge of your word. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' precious name, we have prayed. Amen. And amen. Glory be to the name of the Lord. I'm sure that we all are set for today's Bible studies. The Bible says in the book of Romans chapter 15 and verse 29, Apostle Paul said that I am sure that when I'm coming to you or when I come to you, I will come to you with the fullness of the blessings of the gospel of Christ. So every time we are privileged to receive God's word, we are set for the outpouring of the blessings of the Lord in every area of our life. Therefore, I want you to expect your own encounter today, because nobody ever encountered God's word without a definite touch of the hand of God upon their life. Therefore, in the name of Jesus Christ, as you receive today's message and be part of today's Bible study, I decree that God's blessings will locate you in the name of Jesus Christ. Today, we are going to continue our teaching on the word of prophecy we receive from the Lord. Remember, the Lord said to us on Sunday that in this month of April, let my wisdom strengthen and stabilize your heart. Let my wisdom strengthen and stabilize your heart. And our anchor scripture for the month, as you can remember, is Isaiah chapter 33 and verse number 6. The Bible says that wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability of thy times and the strength of your salvation, and the fear of the Lord is his treasure. So the Lord is expecting every one of us to flow with him on the platform of wisdom to strengthen us, to stabilize our heart, to give us peace and tranquility and serenity on every side in this season of global crisis. And that last Sunday, we commenced a teaching which we titled, unveiling the power of God's wisdom for strength and stability. Unveiling the power of wisdom for strength and stability. And today, by the grace of God, we are going to be doing part two of this teaching. Remember, last Sunday, we took our time to look at the definition of wisdom from God's perspective. Reading from the book of Matthew chapter 7 and verse number 24 to verse number 25. The Bible makes us understand that whosoever heareth this saying of mine and doeth them, he said, I will liken him unto a wise man who built his house upon the rock. And verse 25, the Bible says, and when the storm comes, and the flood comes against the house, and the wind blows against the house, the Bible says it shall not fall, right? That it will be strong, it will be standing strong because it is built upon the solid rock of the Almighty God. He that heareth this saying of mine and doeth them. So from that scripture, we were able to define wisdom as your ability to receive and apply God's word in every area of your life, circumstances notwithstanding. I come again, we define wisdom as the ability to receive and to apply God's word in every area of your life, circumstances notwithstanding. No matter what the prevailing situation may be in your life, you are able to receive God's word, give yourself to God's word, and apply that word you have had unto your life. No matter what is going on, God said that peace, joy, stability, strength, and dominion will continue to be your portion because the power of God's wisdom is at work in your life. Even as you give yourself to receiving God's word continuously and commit yourself to the application of the word that you have received from the Lord. So I want to encourage every one of us to subscribe to this powerful subject of wisdom for strength and dominion in this season of global crisis. And as the Lord liveth, none of you will be crushed in the name of Jesus Christ. In this part two, we shall be looking at the wisdom of time and season. The wisdom of times and season. In the book of 1 Chronicles chapter 12, verse number 32, the Bible spoke about the experience and the life and the dominion and the command of the children of Issachar. The Bible says that the children of Issachar, they had command, they had authority, they had advantage over all of their brethren in the whole of Israel because of one wisdom that was at work in their life, and that is the wisdom of time and season. The Bible says because they understood the mystery of time and season. Therefore, they always know what to do in every season that God brings to them or God allows to come to them. Any season they find themselves, they always had the good knowledge of the wisdom of God, which helped them to know the right steps to take and what to do in order to receive and maximize the blessings and the purpose of God for that season, no matter how challenging and how complicating the season may appear. And because of the understanding of the wisdom of times and seasons, the Bible says that they had good advantage. They were in command over all other of their brethren because the understanding of the wisdom of times and seasons will always give you advantage over everything around you, over people around you, over situations around you. Therefore, in the name of Jesus Christ, as God unveiled to us the mystery of wisdom, of the wisdom of times and seasons in this Bible study, I pray that every one of you, we have command, we have dominion, we have advantage, we have authority over every situation around you right now in the name of Jesus Christ. Therefore, as we proceed in this Bible studies, I want us to read a scripture to drive home this powerful revelation of today. From the book of Ecclesiastes chapter 3, from verse number 1 to verse number 8. In that scripture, the Bible says, to everything there is a season and a time to every purpose under the heaven. A time to be born and a time to die. A time to plant and a time to pluck up that which is planted. A time to kill and a time to heal. A time to break down and a time to build up. A time to weep and a time to laugh. A time to mourn and a time to dance. A time to cast away stones and a time to gather stones together. A time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing. A time to get and a time to lose. A time to keep silence and a time to speak. A time to love and a time to hate. A time of war and a time of peace. Amen. This scripture is, in summarizing this scripture, God is helping us understand that as we go through the journey of life, we are going to be exposed to different seasons in our life. Well, this season can be broadly divided into two seasons. A season, one, a season where everything seems to be going very well. A season that things are rosy. A season that virtually everything is working for your good. Wherever you turn, things are working. Things are just, doors are opening. Turnarounds are coming. There's joy. There's laughter. There's favor. There's good news everywhere. Good testimonies on every side. Things, doors are opening on their own accord unto you. This is one season. A time to born. A time to be born. A time to laugh. A time to rejoice. A time to plant. A time for good things. A time for harvest. Good times. God said that these times are always going to come as we go through the journey of life. They will come to you. You will experience them. But the Bible says we all have to be careful that when we are exposed, when we're experiencing this special season of goodness and testimonies and blessings, that we don't get carried away. This is where some people will get to and say, well, I think everything is working for my good. What do I need God for? So many people feel that, well, God is no longer relevant to them. Like we have seen a lot of people today, because of economic strength, because of good financial positioning, a good leadership structure in their system, they mean that we don't need God anymore. And this is the same God that helps their fathers and mothers and great-great-great-grandparents to stabilize the system and to build the system to produce the result that the children are not enjoying. God said we have to be careful on how we get carried away when things are going well and we suddenly get lost in the blessings and just feel that, well, God is no longer relevant. God said we should be careful, because in the book of John chapter 15 and verse number 5b, the Bible says, without me, you can do nothing. Also, we have the second season, which is a season of challenges. A season where suddenly challenges just come to you from every side. Before you know it, strange things are happening. Inexplicable things are happening. As you are fixing one, another one is opening up. Things are complicated. The more you try to get things to go well, the more things seem to be turning up against you. These are seasons of complexity, a season of complication, a season of questioning, a season where even yourself, you start, if you are not careful, you start doubting yourself and doubting your faith in God, and even doubt God. That is why some people will now come and say, God, why have you forsaken me? No, the Bible says, I will never forsake you. In the book of Psalm 34 and verse 19, it said, my boy, my daughter, my soul, listen to me. Though many are the affliction of the righteous, but the Lord will deliver you out of them all. Many are the challenges. Many could be the troubles. Many could be the crisis. Many could be the attacks. Many could be the commotion around a child of God. But the Bible says that the Lord will deliver us out of them all. He will preserve our bones, and none of them shall be broken. So, a time that you are exposed, which is the season
of difficulties, season of challenges, season of complexity, God said, don't lose your mind. I don't think that God has forgotten you. All you simply need to do, all we simply need to do, is to know the right approach to take, is to know what God has said concerning the different areas that challenges are coming, and we apply ourselves to the word of God that has come to us in that area. Remember, he that heareth this saying of mine and doeth them, I will liken him unto a wise man. Matthew chapter 7 and verse number 24. So what God expects every one of us to do in order to keep a joy, stability, peace, strength, dominion, progress, and advancement, irrespective of prevailing circumstances, irrespective of the challenges that may come around our life, like we have all around in the world right now, is to remember what God has said. And continue to apply ourselves to it and trying to deal with it and confront the situation until the doors begin to open and the season of positive story, a season of positive experience, a season of good testimony begin to manifest again. You know what? I've come to announce to you that no matter how complex the situation around the world may be right now, very soon, a season of testimony will soon come in the name of Jesus Christ. A season of good news, a season of open doors, a season of restoration, a season of healing, a season of blessings, a season of thanksgiving, a season of celebration, a season where everyone again will return and continue to celebrate of what God has done. When I think of the goodness of the Lord and all that he has done for me, you rejoice and glorify. The season is just around the corner. All you simply need to do, all we simply need to do, is to subscribe to the wisdom, to the application of the wisdom of God. At this time, what has God said in the different areas of our life that any of you may be experiencing difficulty right now as this coronavirus pandemic is raging all around the world? Remember, right now, there is this mysterious and dangerous enemy that has invaded the world and is causing sicknesses and diseases. It's causing so much death to many people all around the world. It's causing pain to a lot of people. It's causing panic. It's causing fear in the heart of people. And all these experiences are happening all around us. The Bible says, if you do not want this challenges, if you do not want the complexity that is dominating the world order right now to break you down, to confuse you and to destabilize you, the Bible says at a time like this, we all must subscribe to the wisdom of time and season. A good understanding of time and season will help us to override and overcome the pressure that current situation around the world is putting many people through. And as the Lord liveth, all of you will overcome in the name of Jesus Christ. No matter how complex it may be, I've come to announce to you that it is only for a season. And as the Lord liveth, the season will soon be over in the name of Jesus Christ. The question now is, what do you do? What wisdom do you need to subscribe to in order to keep a joy in strength, in order to keep a joy in peace, in order to keep moving on from glory to glory? You're going to sing in the midst of the complexity. You're going to rejoice and your heart is strengthened and settled and at peace with God and with men, even in this season of this coronavirus pandemic. Now, let's look at some of these few areas. For example, in your spiritual life, which is the number one aspect of your life, which is the foundation of every believer's life, your spiritual life. Lots of people now are a bit disengaged in their spiritual life. And that can make you vulnerable to satanic maneuvering. But for you to keep your spiritual life on guide, to be strengthened spiritually, to keep basking and keep moving from strength to strength in your spiritual life and keep overcoming any opposition, keep moving on and keep gliding on and keep breaking down barriers all through this season of challenges. The Bible gave us some wisdom key to dealing with this situation. Remember, What are these wisdom keys? In the book of Ephesians, chapter 6 and verse number 10, hear what he has to say. The Bible says, finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. Verse 12, for we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, and against spiritual wickedness in high places. So what God is expecting us to do now is to be strong spiritually. This is not the time to put your spiritual life on holiday. This is not the time to go on spiritual holiday. This is the time to even double up your spiritual exercises, double up your spiritual effort. Get into your prayer altar. Study the word of God. Make sure you are connected with, you are connecting with every broadcast that comes your way. Remember Romans chapter 10 and verse 17, faith comes by hearing, and by hearing by the word of God. And it is the word of God that will strengthen your heart. Be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Remember again, in the book of Isaiah chapter 40 and verse number 13, the Bible says, even the youth may faint and be weary, and the young men may utterly fall. But verse 31, the Bible says, but they that wait upon the Lord, they shall renew their strength. They shall mount with wings as eagles. They shall run and not be weary, and they shall walk and not faint. So the Bible says, if the challenges all around can break other people down, even young men, people who think that they have strength, he said that the challenges of life can break them down. But for you and I, as far as we continue to connect ourselves, get closer with God, get closer to God, stay with God, practice our spiritual exercise on a daily basis, the Bible says that every day our strength shall be renewed like that of an eagle. Our mind shall be strengthened. Our life shall be stabilized. Wherever we go, peace follows us. Even though things are falling down every side, but because we have subscribed to the wisdom of God, receiving the word of God and applying ourselves to the word of God every day, the Bible says that we will not be broken down. No matter how many people fall, no matter how many people faint, no matter how many people become weary and confused, the Bible says, as far as you keep subscribing and applying yourself to the wisdom of God, which is receiving God's word and applying God's word in your life every day, especially in your spiritual life, he said that your strength will forever be renewed like that of an eagle. Therefore, in the name of Jesus Christ, in this season of conflict, I decree that God will come to renew your spiritual strength like that of an eagle in the name of Jesus Christ. No evil will prevail against you. No attack will prevail against you. Every weapon of the enemy shot against you and your household, I command them return back to sender. Anywhere your name and the name of members of your household is mentioned for evil, I decree that the fire of God will strike in that place in the name of Christ. May the Lord renew your strength and nothing will turn you back from the Lord in this season. In the name of Jesus Christ. And number two, we talk about our health. Especially in this season, that everybody is afraid. People are afraid for their health because of this virus. You need to understand. For you not to be afraid to think that where something was to break me down, my health will be affected. Listen to what God has to say. The Bible says you have to apply yourself to the wisdom of God in the book of 3 John and verse 2. The Bible says, my beloved, I wish above all things that thou mayest prosper and be in health, even as thy soul prospereth. Come on. Let that wisdom be applicable. Apply that wisdom to your life. I am a child of God. Therefore, sickness and diseases cannot prevail over my body. In the book of Isaiah chapter 53 and verse number 5b, the Bible says, by his stripes we are healed. By his stripes you are healed. By the stripes of Jesus Christ, healing becomes our portion. So even if you feel anything strange in your body, be rest assured that God's healing power is still around you. Plug into it. Ascribe the word of God to your life. Prophesy the word of God. Declare the word of God. And I tell you what, that sickness by itself will disappear in the name of Christ. And also remember the Bible says in the book of Matthew chapter 8 and verse 17 that himself took our infirmity and bear all our sicknesses. So Jesus Christ, always know that every virus that is targeting your life, Jesus Christ has taken it over already and hung it up on the cross of Calvary. That is what we are celebrating this week, which is the death and the resurrection of Jesus Christ, being an EB, the Easter week. Therefore, in the name of Christ, the Lord by his power, in the blood of Jesus Christ, we ensure that every sickness and every disease that is thrown against you, all of them shall be destroyed by the blood in the name of Jesus Christ. And number three is death. These are the things that are going on around the world right now. People are afraid for their health. People are afraid for their spiritual life. Many people's spiritual life is becoming, because many people, for a long time now, people can't go to place of worship, all of that. That must not affect your spiritual life. Subscribe to the wisdom of time and season. It will soon be over. What you simply need to do is that in this season, get more connected in your spiritual life. Be strong in the Lord. Then number two, always know that Jesus Christ paid the price on the cross of Calvary to deliver you from sicknesses and diseases and to guarantee your divine health on a daily basis. Don't tell me that I heard that one pastor has been affected by the disease. I heard that a reverend died. I heard that a bishop died. Because are you the bishop? Are you the reverend? You are all in your class with your God. So it is what you believe. It is what wisdom you apply yourself to that will determine what will happen in your life. Listen to this. He that heareth this saying of mine. Did he say he that is a bishop? Did he say he that is a pastor? Did he say he that is a reverend? But he that heareth this saying of mine and doeth them, say that man shall be likened unto a wise man. And look at what he said in the book of Proverbs chapter 25 verse 5. He said that a wise man is strong and a man of knowledge, you know, increases strength. So every day as you subscribe yourself, as you subscribe to the wisdom of God by applying God's word in all areas of your life, the Bible says that you are going to move from strength to strength like that of an eagle, and you will run and not be weary, and you walk and ever fail. And the next area we are going to look now is the area of death. There's so much news of death going on around the world. Now, what will deliver you from the panic and the fear of death? In the book of Psalm 118 and verse number 17, hear what the wisdom of God has to say. It said that, I shall not die. You shall not die. Your children shall not die. Members of your household shall not die. Married to Kashiaga. He said, but we shall live. You shall live to declare the works of God. Which means that death is not your portion. Premature death is not your portion. Premature death is not the portion of your children. So in this season, I want you to know that your name is not registered for death. Therefore, whosoever has whispered to you, every devil whispered to you that the death that is going around the world will kill you, I command that verdict be reversed in the name of Jesus Christ. I've come to announce to you that death is not your portion. Remember, even if somebody is shooting you from somewhere, in the book of Isaiah chapter 54 and verse number 17, the Bible says, no weapon formed against you, no weapon formed against me, no weapon formed against us shall prosper. And every tongue that rises up against us in judgment, he said, we shall condemn. He said, for this is the heritage of the servants of God, and the righteousness is of me, says the Lord. So, no weapon of death, no weapon of sickness, no weapon of destruction, no weapon of affliction formed against you will prosper. So, anywhere and anyone that is shooting arrows and weapons of death and sickness and disease against you, God said, you have the authority to return them back to center. He said, and you shall condemn. Therefore, now I join my faith with you to decree that every arrow and every weapon of death, every weapon of sickness and disease, every weapon of barrenness, every weapon of miscarriage, every weapon of evil that the enemies are shooting out against men and women in this season, I command them concerning your life be returned back to sender in the name of Jesus Christ. Remember, you shall not die, but you shall live to declare the works of the Lord. This is the word of God. This is the wisdom of God unto you. And I pray that you subscribe unto it. The number four thing, which is another common challenge of the season, is the area of finance. You are thinking that you are going to be broken down. You are thinking that where poverty is around you. That is not true. The wisdom of God in the book of Philippians chapter 4 and verse 19, the Bible says, and the Lord shall supply, my God shall supply all your need according to his riches in glory through our Lord Jesus Christ. So abundance is your portion. Supernatural supply is your portion. No matter what has happened around your job, no matter what the enemy is whispering right now, I have come to announce you that miraculously and mysteriously, God will come to open doors of financial favor unto you in the name of Jesus Christ. Lack and want will not prevail in your household. Lack and want will not prevail in your family. In the day that you thought that nothing will come, suddenly God will send news of favor of financial encounter to you in the name of Jesus Christ. That's what the Bible says in the book of Psalm 34 and verse number 10. It said that the young lion do lack and suffer hunger, but they that seek the Lord, they shall not want any good thing. Are you not a servant of God? Are you not a child of God? So why do you think, why are you allowing the devil to cause panic of lack and want, of poverty, of penury around you? The Bible says, the Lord will supply all your need according to his riches in glory. Let that wisdom dominate that in this season of global crisis, jobs are shut down, companies are closing, the Lord will open doors of financial supply unto you in the name of Jesus Christ. Then, this is all you need. Keep subscribing to the wisdom of God in all areas of your life. Because of time, I'm going to be closing down. I would have touched all areas, but always remember that in every area where you are challenged, every season you are challenged, any season of your life that you are challenged at any time, the wisdom of times and season has, by God's definition, has already put in place certain wisdom key that you need to subscribe yourself to so as to override them and clear off every barrier that the devil may set your way pattern. That is why the Bible says in the book of 1 Peter chapter 5 and verse number 10, it said that the God of all grace who has called us unto his own glory, that after we have suffered for a while, he said, the God will return. He said that he will perfect all that concerns us. He will establish us. He will strengthen us. And he will settle us. Therefore, in the name of Jesus Christ, at the end of this global crisis, God will perfect all that concerns you. Even in the midst of these challenges, the Lord will strengthen you. The Lord will empower you. The Lord will defend you. The Lord will increase his grace upon your life. Above all, God will settle you on every side. This is where I want to draw the curtain today. But let me remind you once again. Isaiah chapter 33 and verse number 6. Wisdom and knowledge shall be the stability of the times. This time we are. All we need to have stability and peace and strength to keep moving on with joy and celebration until God brings an end to this global crisis. It shall continue to subscribe to the knowledge and the wisdom of God. Remember, what is the wisdom of God? Matthew chapter 7 and verse number 24. In the hearing this saying of mine, and doing them, I will like him unto a wise man that put his house upon a rock, and no challenge all around the world will ever break them down. I've come to announce to you that the wisdom of God will strengthen you and stabilize you through this crisis, and none of you shall be broken down in the name of Jesus Christ. Remember again, Psalm 34 and verse 19 and 20. Many are the affliction of the righteous, but the Lord will deliver him out of them all. Will preserve your bone. No one shall be broken. Your family shall not be broken. Your finances shall not be broken. Your body will not be broken. Your womb will not be broken. Your children will not be broken. Your career will not be broken. Your mind will not be broken. Your marriage will not be broken. Nothing will break your family. As the Lord liveth, the wisdom of God, as you apply it to every area of your life, I decree that peace and stability and strength will be your testimony. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. In Jesus' precious name, we have prayed. Amen. Glory to God. Remember, we are in the Holy Week. We are just in the week of Easter. Therefore, I want to encourage every one of you to make sure that you make yourself available for all the Easter
services, the Good Friday service, and the Easter Sunday services. We are going to be, you know, transmitting online as well through our live broadcast. So make sure you get yourself ready to be part of all of the services. Friday, the Good Friday service, like I said to you before, is going to start at 7:30 p.m. And by the grace of God, the Sunday service, Easter Sunday service, will start at 10:30 a.m. All the live broadcasts shall be sent to you on time so that you can get connected. Make sure you always engage in prayers and in praises and worship unto God. On Sunday, always have your bath for time. Dress as if you're on your way to church. Wear your suit, wear your tie, wear your gown, wear everything that makes you look good. Wear your dress. Dress your children up. Sit them down. Let them know that Jesus reigns. Read your call to worship. Read your Bible study. Do everything as if you are sitting in the cathedral. Remember, the Bible says, where two or three are gathered in my name, there I am in their midst. You never gather to see the beauty when you come to the cathedral. You gather to encounter God. And this time, God has ordained that we gather in our own house. What a joy. Why are you waking up and attending Sunday service with pyjamas? No. Why are you attending Sunday service with a shirt? No. Is that how you are going to come to cathedral if you are going to attend the service in the cathedral? So get yourself ready. Decorate yourself. After them, snap some nice picture and tell the devil that corona cannot be found in your territory. Be blessed and enjoy every bit of this Easter. I know that there is a cut down in shopping. Come on, that will stop you from still ordering your Easter turkey, Easter chicken, and Easter beef. Come on, cook nice meal for your family that day, delicious one, and let everybody enjoy the Easter like never before. You know what? The devil cannot take away our joy in the name of Jesus Christ. So enjoy every bit of this season. And by the grace of God, we shall be having a 3 days fasting and prayer beginning from tomorrow, Wednesday, Upper Friday. So make sure you connect to it every day from 12 midnight or 46 p.m. the next day. Make sure you get connected, praying and pray. If there's a time to pray, this is the time. Pray for the world. Remember to also commit our Prime Minister, Boris Johnson, into the hands of God, so that corona will leave him alone, so that he can come back and give us leadership as a country until we overcome. He will know that the Lord will keep him and strengthen him in the name of Jesus Christ. May the Lord bless all of you and enjoy the rest of the evening. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Amen. But surely, God's goodness and mercy shall follow us all the days of our life, and we shall dwell in the house of the Lord forever and ever. Amen. Therefore, we are blessed, we are lifted, and we are going higher. 2020, our year of higher level, our year of higher level, God's wisdom is taking me higher. God bless you and have a wonderful evening.